Many centuries ago, after the last ice age, after many dark and insufferable winters, the warm waters of the Gulf Stream, like a friendly invading army, pierced the magnificent glaciers. And they crumbled with a roar, flooding the sea with icy waters. And as the ice melted, the land rose, and its beginning is revered in the anthem they sing of their homeland. The words, furrowed and weathered, it rises forth, and they called it Norway. This land that has given us the explorations of the Vikings, the magnificent fjords, the land of the midnight sun, the land of the northern lights. So it was in February of 1994, Norway for the second time would play host to the Winter Olympic athletes of the world. Representative of the sun would make its way through the cities and towns. Its final resting place, the beloved mountain village of Lillehammer. Afternoon of Saturday, February 12th, thousands gathered for the first act. The opening ceremonies of the 17th Olympic Winter Games. King Harald V arrives in the stadium. The opening ceremonies pay tribute to Norway's majestic past, its culture and tradition of folklore, of songs, dances, legends, fairy tales. Alphabetically, in the language of the host nation, the flag bearers lead their country's athletes into the arena. There are moments in every lifetime when one believes the highest mountain peaks can be climbed, that there are no horizons that cannot be reached. Such are the dreams of every athlete marching this day. Yeah. Finally, the men and women of Norway. As they march in, there are remembrances of the past. 42 years ago, Oslo, Norway's capital, played host for the 6th Olympic Winter Games. Then Norwegian athletes did honor to their country, winning more Olympic medals than any nation. The athletes and spectators of the world are greeted by Gerhard Heiberg, president of the Lillehammer Olympic Organizing Committee.
On behalf of the Lillehammer Olympic Organizing Committee, I am pleased and honored to welcome our neighbors of the world to the city of Lillehammer.
Ten years ago, we were in Sarajevo.
President of the International Olympic Committee, Juan Antonio Samaranch.
Sarajevo, whose people for over 2 years have suffered too much. I invite everyone, everywhere around the world, may even in your own homes, to stand up for a moment's silence in memory of the city of Sarajevo.
Thank you.
The message of the Olympic movement is stronger than ever. Please stop fighting. Please stop killing. Drop your guns, please.
King Harald V opens the games.
Jeg erklærer herved de 17. Olympiske vinterleker på Lillehammer for åpnet.
The Olympic flag enters the arena. Borne by 8 Norwegian Olympic legends. Finally, the Olympic flame arrives. Crown Prince Haakon lights the Olympic flame. On Sunday, February 20th, in the town of Hundefossen, 9 miles north of Lillehammer, the final runs of the two-man bobsled are being held. It is a magnificent day for Switzerland. Their two sleds win the gold and silver medals. For driver Gustav Vader of the number one Swiss team, it was an historic occasion. He became the first driver in Olympic history to defend the two-man championship. He won his first gold 2 years earlier in Albertville when he became Switzerland's only gold medal winner of the games. As the medal winners were celebrating, the long-awaited ski jumping competition was getting underway in Olympic Park, the site of the opening day ceremonies 1 week earlier. Ski jumping is part of Norway's great Olympic heritage. Norway's ski jumpers won the first 6 gold medals, starting at Chamonix in 1924, when the Winter Games began, through the 1952 Games in Oslo. Norway gave the world the legendary Birger Ruud, who won successive gold medals in 1932 and 1936. But after the 1952 Oslo Games, Norwegian jumpers went into a disastrous decline. During the next 10 Olympic Games leading to Lillehammer, only one Norwegian jumper would stand on the top step of the victory podium. This is 26-year-old Espen Bredesen of Norway. 2 years ago in Albertville, Bredesen was expected to regain Norway's lost glory as one of the favorites to win the gold on both the normal and large hills. But he finished third from last on the large hill and dead last on the normal hill. Bredesen's embarrassment in Albertville was further advanced by the Norwegian press, who nicknamed him Espen the Eagle. An undisguised comparison to Eddie Edwards, Great Britain's only jumper at the 1988 Calgary Olympics, whose amateur attempts forever earned him the title of Eddie the Eagle. For Espen Bredesen, the nickname Espen the Eagle was a humiliating association.
When people back home compared me to him, I think that was an insult for me, because I saw myself as a top athlete. Still, I didn't get the results, but I didn't think that was pretty nice, so.
After the 1992 Olympics, Bredesen perfected the V style of jumping used by all the medal winners in Albertville. Many victories followed, and soon he became a Norwegian national hero. The new V style revolutionized ski jumping. Formerly, jumpers kept their skis forward and parallel in the air. In the V style, the ski tips are spread apart in a V, giving the jumper greater lift, increasing their distance by 5 to 7 meters. Bredesen's main opposition on both hills is expected to come from 29-year-old Jens Weisflog of Germany. As a 19-year-old at the 1984 Sarajevo Games, he won the gold medal on the small hill and a silver medal on the big hill. But in the Calgary and Albertville Games that followed, Weisflog was never in contention. After Albertville, Weisflog, like Bredesen, learned the V-style. And leading to Lillehammer, he and the Norwegian were battling it out for top honors.
You could say I came from the top to the bottom and back to the top again. After winning the gold and silver medals 10 years ago in Sarajevo, I became frustrated. Injuries and learning the new V-style made my competitions difficult. But as you can see, I am durable. None of the winners from Sarajevo or Calgary are still around. Only Jens Weisflog.
It is 1 p.m. Sunday, February 20th. The scene, the 120-meter hill, the first of 3 ski jumping events. More than 40,000 people surround the landing area at the bottom of the hill. 58 men are entered. Each will take 2 jumps. There are some misconceptions shared by many about ski jumping. The term 120-meter hill is not the distance from the top of the in-run. Rather, it is the distance from the takeoff point to the normal landing area. There is also an optical illusion for spectators. Once in flight, the jumpers rarely soar more than 10 to 15 feet off the ground. Thank you. After more than half the jumpers had taken their first attempt, Andreas Goldberger of Austria leads. Now the 44th contestant, Jens Weißflog of Germany. Weißflog moves into first place, sending the former leader, Andreas Goldberger of Austria, back to second. He remains in first place after the next 11 contestants. Now, Espen Bredesen, the 56th jumper. Spectacular, 6 meters farther than Weißflog. With high style points added to the distance, Bredesen leads Weißflog by more than 10 points.
After Bredesen's first jump, I gave up thoughts of winning the gold medal. But I wanted to win a medal, any medal. It doesn't matter whether it is gold, silver, or bronze. My thoughts were to get off a good second jump. To make up 10 points against Bredesen is impossible.
At the end of the first run, Bredesen is first, Weißflog second, Goldberger, Austria, third, and Masahiko Harada, Japan, fourth. Harada is the star of the Japanese four-man squad that is a favorite to win the team championship gold medal to be contested in 2 days. On the second run, the jumpers will go off in reverse order of their first round standings. Bredesen will be the last jumper, following Harada, Goldberger, and Weißflog. The second run, it soon becomes apparent that the victor will be among the last four jumpers. Harada puts himself out of contention. His jump is 21 meters less than his first effort and drops him to 10th position. Andreas Goldberger follows. Goldberger ensures himself one of the medals. Now Jens Weißflog. Second longest jump of the day. Only Bredesen's first round effort is longer. Weißflog moves into first place. Espen Bredesen will make the last jump of the afternoon. Bredesen has 15 seconds once the green light is flashed. He will await a signal from his coach below for the most favorable wind conditions. is 11 meters short of Weisflog's second jump.
It was a strange feeling. I didn't know whether my second jump of 133 meters was enough. Before he jumped, I thought there was no chance. Then I thought maybe there was a chance. It was a strange feeling.
Weisflog wins by 8 points. Jens Weisflog has made Olympic history. 10 years after winning his first gold medal, he has won again. Two days later, the final of the team championship. 12 countries are entered. 4 men on each team. The winner is decided by the combined total of the 4 team members in each of the 2 rounds. 4 countries are the favorites: Japan, Germany, Austria, and Norway. Throughout the afternoon, the Japanese jumpers are magnificent. And as the final jumpers get underway, Japan leads Germany by the incredible total of 55 points. Austria is third, and Norway fourth. At the top of the hill, Jens Weisflog prepares for his last jump. 2 days earlier in the Big Hill competition, he was more than 10 points behind Bredesen and won. Now Germany is 55 points behind the Japanese.
Before my second jump, I thought we could not win. I was fortunate in winning the Big Hill, being 10 points behind. But 55 points behind, a victory could not happen. I went over to Masahiko Harada, who would jump after me, and congratulated him on the Japanese victory. Harada was the world champion on the normal hill in 1993, and everyone expected that his final jump would probably be just a formality.
Weisflog takes his last jump. meters, the longest jump of the day. Germany has secured second place. Now it is time for Harada of Japan. On his first attempt, Harada jumped 122 meters. If he jumps 105 meters on his second attempt, 30 meters less than Weisflog, the gold medal will still go to Japan. It is the shortest jump of any competitor on the top 3 teams, 97.5 meters. Another miracle for Jens Weisflog and his German team. Germany first, Japan second, Austria third. Now a controversy. Bredesen believes Weisflog behaved in an unsportsmanlike fashion congratulating the Japanese before his final jump.
I don't know what other people does normally, but I just wanted the Weisflog to know that I don't think that was the right time or the right moment to say something like that. And also, you saw how it went, so.
I have missed this great opportunity. I knew immediately when I landed it was not enough. It had nothing to do with Weisflog talking to me before I jumped. It was just a bad effort. I could not get the energy to leave the arena, even though there is one jumper left. My teammates were very nice to me. They said that was an honor to win the silver medal. At the victory ceremony, we made a joke of it. You can see us stumble as we stepped onto the platform, a reference to what happened that afternoon.
The ski jumpers would now have 2 free days before the start of their last event on the 90-meter hill. In the interim, there was great drama in the men's giant slalom. The hero of the afternoon was 30-year-old Markus Wassmeier of Germany, who shocked the world by defeating Italy's Alberto Tomba, Luxembourg's Marc Girardelli, and Norway's Kjetil André Aamodt, the gold, silver, and bronze medal winners 2 years earlier in Albertville. For Wassmeier, it was his second gold medal here in Lillehammer. 6 days earlier, he won the Super G. In 2 previous Olympics, Wassmeier failed to win a medal. It is Friday, February 25th, the ski jump competition on the Normal Hill, a 90-meter event. 58 men are entered. For Jens Weisflog, it is an opportunity to create Olympic history, to tie Finland's Matti Nykänen's record of 3 gold medals at 1 Olympics, 4 overall. If he wins a medal, he will also tie Nykänen for the most medals ever won, 5. But in the 3 days since the German team victory, many in the press have criticized Weisflog for his words with Japan's Masahiko Harada before his final jump. For Espen Bredesen, it is the last opportunity to give Norway its first ski jumping gold medal in 42 years. In the first round, Lasse Ottesen, Bredesen's teammate, goes into the early lead with a leap of 102.5 meters. He stays in front throughout most of the first round. Now the 46th jumper is Espen Bredesen.
Well, I felt much more aggressive than I did in the big hill, because even if it was a small hill, I can jump very good. I knew I also did a couple of mistakes in the big hill and I wasn't going to do them again, so I was much more aggressive that day than I've ever been before.
Bredesen's jump is 2 meters less than Ottesen's, but his style points are almost near perfect as compared to those of his countrymen. Bredesen moves into first place. Now the 55th jumper, Jens Weisflog of Germany. Meters. Weisflog is in 5th place.
It was frustrating. The wind was not good when it was my time to jump. Many of the spectators were whistling when it was my turn. I had read the newspapers that said I was the most unpopular sportsman at the Olympics. I don't think I deserved that.
In the time between the 1st and 2nd rounds, the spectators had already received news of a magnificent Norwegian victory on the ski slopes 9 miles away. In the Alpine combined, a clean sweep for the Norwegians. Lasse Schuss won the gold, Kjetil André Aamodt the silver, and Harald Nilsson the bronze. Now, here on the Normal Hill, there were expectations that this day might end as the greatest in Norwegian Olympic history. The 2nd round begins. The many thousands at the bottom of the hill and millions throughout the world will have to watch more than 50 jumpers before the leaders compete. First-place finisher in the first run, Bredesen will jump last, just after his teammate, Lasse Ottesen. For Bredesen, there is much irony. 2 years ago in Albertville, he finished last in this event. The the 52nd contestant, Dieter Thoma of Germany, Weissblanc's teammate. Thoma was seventh after the first round. meters, tied for the longest jump of the day. He moves into first place with six men left. It is now time for Jens Weissblanc. His two-round total leaves him in second place, one half a point behind his teammate, Dieter Thoma. The 57th and next-to-last ski jumper, Lasse Ottesen of Norway. He moves past Thoma into first place. Weissblanc falls back to third. Now the final moments of the drama are at hand. The last contestant in the competition, Espen Bredesen of Norway.
Well, it was pretty much the same as in the big hill. I was the last jumper also in the big hill, but I was now thinking much more what I was supposed to do in that particular jump. I didn't think about if I'm going to be the winner or be in second place. I didn't think about that.
The longest jump of the afternoon. Espen Bredesen has done it. 2 years after coming in last, he has earned the right to stand on the top step of the victory podium. Lasse Ottesen, Norway, second. Dieter Thoma, Germany, third. Jens Weissblanc, Germany, fourth. Weissblanc has missed winning a medal by one half a point.
It was not my happiest time. I jumped poorly, and the press and the people were not behind me. Now that it is over, perhaps it is right that Norway did so well to win the final event. In front of all their people, in their own country, their homeland.
That evening, thousands gathered for the victory platform ceremony to hear the Norwegian national anthem played twice. Once in honor of the three Norwegians who won all the medals in the Alpine combined, and the second in honor of Espen Bredesen and Lasse Ottesen, the gold and silver medalists of the 90-meter hill.
When I'm thinking about it now, I can feel it. Being in Lillehammer, in my own country, with all of the thousand spectators watching it, was, I have this thing in my heart. I can take it out anytime I want, and I can feel it. It's something special. And I did it. I just couldn't believe it, but I could see my Norwegian flag, all the people around. I could see that, and I just, it's happening. Just take it in and have fun, you know?